Let's look at how to record time card hours for all employees at once. Now the example I use will be to record a holiday, but you could use this for other purposes as well. So we'll go to Functions and we're going to use the Batch Post Time Card feature. Here we'll select all employees who are employed as of a particular date. Usually we want this to be the holiday itself, so I'm going to be recording the 4th of July holiday, which in this calendar year happened to officially fall on July 5th, and so everybody employed as of that date would be eligible. Then I'm going to base my posting on their primary work area. So if they work in the infant's room or the toddler's room, it's going to default to that. Over here, I'm going to pick the pay code to use. And since this is a holiday, I want to use the standard pay code called holiday. And below that, I'll pick the date that I want this recorded on each person's time card. You'll notice that it's defaulting to July 9th because today happens to be July 9th. So it's later in the week after the holiday has already passed. And that's what you want to do. If the holiday's on Monday, wait and record it on Tuesday or later in the week. But in order for people to be able to check in and out as normal, you want to make sure you record the holiday after it's already passed. So I'm going to change this date to the 5th because that's the day I want this recorded on their time card. And I'll make a comment in here, 4th of July, just like that. And then the in and out times I want to add up to 8 hours since most people will qualify for an 8-hour benefit. And I'll click Next. I get a list of all the people who are employed as of that date, and then I can select them all at once. Now, if I need to, I can make an individual change. Let's say, for example, Linda might be a new employee, and maybe she doesn't qualify for paid holidays yet, so I might uncheck her. And maybe Wayne, perhaps he's a part-time employee, and I only want to give him a half day of a holiday, so I could just change this time and right here on the screen. Then I'll go ahead and click Process, and it's going to record all of these hours directly to those employee time cards. It leaves the one person on the screen that I chose not to process. So now I'll exit, and we'll take a look at an employee and see how this affects her time card. I'll go to the time card screen, and if we look, there it is, holiday, in her normal work area, the infant's room, dated July 5th, and then the in and out times that we had specified. And we'll go ahead and exit. So this will not only be recorded automatically on the time card, but it will also show up as a benefit on the employee benefits screen. So we'll take a look at Tammy's benefit screen. It will show up as a used benefit on the used tab, and we'll see there's the date, 8 hours, holiday. And that's all there is to tracking holiday hours in ProCare.